After cataracts, glaucoma is the second leading cause of blindness worldwide. Unlike cataracts, glaucoma causes irreversible blindness by damaging the optic nerve. Although the exact mechanism of optic nerve damage is not fully understood, in most clinical cases, raised intraocular pressure is the problem. Eye pressure is the fluid pressure inside the eye, averaging from 10 to 21 millimeters of mercury. During glaucoma, eye pressure usually becomes greater than 21, causing optic nerve compression and decreased ocular blood supply. Over time, these changes subsequently lead to atrophy of optic nerve head and erode a patient's eyesight. Remember that to have good vision, an intact optic nerve to relay visual information from eyes to brain cortex is necessary. Normally, the eye fluid is produced by the ciliary body, then flows through the pupil into the anterior chamber, and finally, leaves the eye at the angle between the iris and cornea, so-called iridocorneal angle. Any imbalance between eye fluid secretion and drainage can affect intraocular pressure and therefore induce glaucoma. Glaucoma is mainly classified into open angle and narrow angle. As their name suggests, the difference is attributable to the iridocorneal angle. Open angle glaucoma is the most common glaucoma in which the iridocorneal angle is wide and open, while narrow angle glaucoma is caused by closure of iridocorneal angle, impairing fluid drainage and raising eye pressure. Clinical symptoms vary depending on glaucoma type. Since in open-angle glaucoma eye pressure builds up gradually, affected people rarely experience symptoms in its early stages. So, open-angle glaucoma is often detected incidentally during visual exam. If left undiagnosed, progressive optic nerve damage finally impairs visual field, causing blind spots in your peripheral vision and subsequent tunnel vision in the late stages. Tunnel vision means that central vision is normal but peripheral vision is missing. Unfortunately, the vision loss cannot be regained anymore. Patients with chronic narrow-angle glaucoma are mostly symptom-free as well. By contrast, acute narrow-angle glaucoma almost always develops unbearable symptoms, including intense eye pain and headache, blurred vision, eye redness, nausea and vomiting. In this case, optic nerve damage can occur within a few of hours. Thereby, unlike open-angle glaucoma, narrow-angle glaucoma is a true ophthalmic emergency that can cause permanent visual defect if not treated early. In short, acute narrow-angle glaucoma presents with various eye symptoms and thereby is diagnosed early on, while open-angle and chronic narrow-angle glaucoma can erode your vision before you notice any symptoms, and because of that, people at risk for glaucoma must get regular complete eye exam as a screening test for glaucoma. But, what are the risk factors? Generally, it's better to have a baseline eye screening at age 40, since signs of glaucomatous optic nerve damage may start to appear at this age. Besides, family history of glaucoma, certain medical conditions such as diabetes and hypertension, severe nearsightedness or farsightedness, can put you at risk of glaucoma. So, it's wise to see a doctor if you have any of these conditions. In practice, anti-glaucoma medicines are used to reduce eye pressure. Beta blockers like timolol and butoxolol, alpha-adrenergic agents like apraclonidine and bromonidine, carbonic anhydrase inhibitors like acetazolamide and dorzolamide, work through lowering production of eye fluid. On the other hand, prostaglandin analogs such as latanoprost and bimatoprost, and cholinergic drugs like pilocarpine, act to increase evacuation of eye fluid, thereby reducing eye pressure. All mentioned drugs are effective in both narrow-angle and open-angle glaucoma. Besides, an important nutrient that has to do with normal vision is vitamin B12. To learn about bizarre symptoms of B12 deficiency including abnormal vision, watch the next video.